I'm Simon, and I'm here at AirBeamTV to get you started with your first mirroring session using your iPhone or iPad and your TV. Today, I am using my iPhone XR, not showing off, but you can use any iOS device. What you do need to do is make sure it is updated to iOS 12. So you can do that by going in your settings, and I'm not going to explain it. You can work that part out. Okay, just in case my dad's watching, I will explain. You click Settings, then General, then Software Update. And hey presto, you're welcome. I've got a Samsung TV, so I've got the Mirror for Samsung app here on my phone. Next thing is you need to make sure that your TV and your phone are connected to the same wireless network. So on the phone, I'll go to Settings, I will go to Wi-Fi, and I'll make sure I'm connected to my home network, whatever that is. This is AirBeamTV TP-Link 5 GHz. And on the TV, I will do the same thing. So I'll go to the menu, I'm gonna scroll to General, which is General in French. And then I'm gonna go to Network, Open Network Settings, and that will give you the option of wireless or wired. If you do have a wired connection, so you just plug your TV into your modem or router, that's the best way to do it. But today we're gonna go wireless. So I'll click on that, and then that's the same network as on my phone. So we are good to go. And now what I need to do is open the app for the first time. Here we go. So the app has opened, and straight away up top, it says TV Samsung 2017, and there's a little check mark next to it. That's this guy. So underneath that, select mirror Samsung TV. I'm gonna press that. It pops up a little screen recording pop-up. On mine, it's got camera roll. It's got mirror Samsung TV. So I'm gonna click mirror Samsung TV and then start broadcast. Gives a little countdown. It's pretty exciting. And then it hopefully should appear on here. What you might find if it's your first time doing it is you get this guy. You must give permission to connect your device to this TV. We do want to give permission because we do want to connect it. So I'm gonna click allow. And then the magic has happened. Look at that, straight away. You can now see everything on my screen on the big screen. Now there is a little delay of like 1 to 3 seconds, but basically if you're looking at photos or videos, that's not gonna be a problem. The only thing is if you want a game, it's not really suitable for that. So next up, I'm gonna go into a browser so you can see what kind of thing we're doing in there. We recommend using
Puffin Browser
because that will allow you to mirror the sound from your phone also onto the TV. Safari and Chrome don't allow that.
Puffin Browser.
Downloaded that from the App Store already. Here it is on my screen. Gonna open that up. Oh, and look, it's opened up to Amazon.com, the shopping channel, not sponsored. It's fun, isn't it? Sometimes maybe you wanna look at Amazon with your imaginary girlfriend. Pick some stuff out for Christmas and birthdays. I don't know what you guys wanna get into. Let's watch a video. That's one of the coolest things about this. So I'm gonna go to Vimeo, where all the best short films are housed. Oh, look at this. A film called Renaissance. I'm gonna press play on there, and that should pretty shortly pop up on this screen. Now, of course, it's showing in the little window here. I'm gonna press full screen. I'm gonna turn it on its side, and sure enough, there it is. Hopefully you can hear the sound coming out of there. That's the sound coming out of the TV. You gotta make sure you turn the sound on your TV up, sound on your iPhone down. One thing to note, if you have the mute switch switched to on, you're not gonna get the sound through. So you gotta have that off, sound turned down on the iPhone, sound turned up on the TV. And as you can see, this screen is on that screen. And there's the sound coming out as well. Oh, who's this guy? This looks like a really good short film. I would love to watch. That's it. How long did that take? 2 minutes? That's pretty simple, and that was my first time using the app as well. So hopefully it will be as easy for you. If you do have any questions or queries or problems, you can get in touch with our support team. All the details are at the end of the video. They're on Facebook Messenger, or you can just email them like it's the year 2005. In the meantime, I've been Simon. Happy mirroring. Do I have to say happy mirroring? Happy mirroring.